Hey everyone, welcome back to Build. I'm your host, Brittany Jones Cooper. The new book, 96 Words for Love, is a modern retelling of a classic Indian legend about love, family, and following your dreams. It was co-authored by fashion designer Rachel Roy and her daughter, Ava Dash, who both join us today to discuss the new book. Welcome, guys.
Thanks for having us.
Hi. Yes. I just want to say before we start off, is today your birthday?
Today is my birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. The big 4-5.
There you go. I love in doing research. I was like, wait, it's a date? That's, oh my God, that's amazing.
My birthday, the birthday of the book.
Yes. Thank you for spending
and
your
actually,
birthday.
Actually, thank you. And Martin Luther King's birthday, his actual birthday.
Icons. So many icons. So let's talk about the book. I have a great relationship with my mother, but I cannot imagine sitting down and writing a book together. So first, I just want to talk to you guys about where did this idea come from to do this together?
So my mom and I realized that there have been many retellings of Greek myths, yet there haven't really been any retellings of Indian love stories and Indian myths. And being that she's half Indian, we felt that it could be our duty to be the first kind of to start that. Yeah. And so we came across the perfect story to retell, a classic love story about Shakuntala. And it's basically about a young girl who falls in love and forgets who she is, and until she remembers who she is, the love of her life doesn't remember her. So it's kind of about her discovering herself and just coming to be who she is.
That's what the original love story, the legend, is about. And Ava, we were in the family room, and she was working. She was a junior in high school. She's a freshman mm-hmm. in college now. She was working on English and working on a Greek myth, and I asked her if she knew any Indian love stories, and she said, no, you haven't taught me any, which is kind of how we got the idea to bring it out. You know, this beautiful love story, which first started as a love story from a mother to a daughter inspired by my father, ended up a love story to the world.
And let's talk about the main character, Raya, because in reading it, I felt like she was maybe a mix of both of you. She sort of pulled from where you are now in life, but also having the mixed ancestry and those similarities I saw for you. So in developing that character, how did you decide who she was going to be?
Well, I think that we definitely created a life in her that I would like to live out myself, following your dream and not necessarily doing what you think is supposed to be planned out for you. And during the time that we were writing this, I was definitely at that crossroads of what's going to happen after high school and do I go to college? And
it's literally what Ava was going through at the time. So I possibly could have written it, but it could not have been authentic without Ava's voice and her telling me what her friends would and would not believe, down to changing exact words into a vocabulary that she felt they would use versus what I was writing, which apparently they do not use.
That was actually one of my favorite things about it was the tone and the terms she uses with her friends and like saying like homegirl or like she fell ass up off of something. And I was like, oh, this is really funny. This
I
is
have
how,
no
like,
idea. Yeah that's, yeah. that's all Ava in keeping it very authentic. And I think that making the original story modern is a way that hopefully other young adults and adults alike can learn about such rich, beautiful, exquisite history that India has to offer.
Definitely. And what was the writing process like?
It was hard. it was work. What Ava and I both are good at and probably what most people are good at are the ideas, right? But coming up with the actual material is forcing yourself to sit down. It's forcing yourself to read and reread, write and rewrite. Mm-hmm. And it's like making your child do homework. So there were times that we did not like each other at all. But to see the final product and to know that it's, in a way, this love story to Ava, to the world, it was all worth it. All the arguments.
Yeah, how about for you? What was it like writing with your mom?
I mean, kind of like she said, making your kid do homework, where she'd be like, all right, we're doing this now. I don't care what it is you have planned, we're doing this. But at the end of the day, it was all worth it, and it was fun. And it was a really good learning experience for me because I'd never written a book before. Writing was never really my strong suit 100%, so it was nice having my mom to bounce ideas off of and just to write it together.
Yeah. And I would imagine there was a fair amount of research that went into this as well, because the whole thing is this young girl decides to go spend some time in an ashram. But when I'm reading it, there's all these details about the country of India, cities, different names. So what was that process like, gathering all of that together to make sure it was accurate?
Yes, that's a great question. Ava and I have been together twice and
to
India twice. And so we have that very visual memory, which helped to kind of inform the story. But yeah, we definitely had to Google a lot, and especially in terms of the ashrams. I wanted to make sure that it's a place that a kid would go, right? Like, who's going to pick up and leave their life? And so it had to be somewhat comfortable, somewhat special, and very believable. And I did so much research on it that now I'm going in February.
I was going to ask, did this inspire? Because it made me want to go have my own moment.
I am going.
They did.
Yes. And so that was a made-up place, but I am going to the closest place that I found doing all of this research.
And part of Raya's journey is that she's reconnecting with her family's history without giving too much away, and her grandmother. For you, was there any extra reason why you wanted to take this journey yourself?
Yes, definitely. My father has been such an inspiration as an immigrant from southern India. Growing up, he was so strict and at times very hard to please. And so until you're an adult, it's difficult to look back and see all of the whys and to connect the dots. And he forced me to go to a certain college, so much so that he filled out the application, packed my suitcases when I refused because I was so stubborn, and then got on the airplane with me. And if he hadn't have done that, we lived in Northern California, flew me to Washington, D.C. If he hadn't have done that, I'd probably still be working in a mall like I was when he picked me up and forced me to do that. So it takes that tough love that I now understand so well. And so it originated from wanting to thank him in a way that I thought he would be proud of and that he would understand.
And that's one of the themes in the book, is that kind of pressure to make a commitment to something forever, like you do have to do when you're 17 and 18.
Great way to put it.
Applying to a college. I mean, that's
how you feel.
It's taken straight from the character, though. I read the line, and she was like, her friend said forever, and she was like, yeah, that's a lot. So is that something that helped you inform the character? Was you kind of going through it at the same time?
Yeah, that's definitely how I felt, especially just being in high school and being a senior and having some of my friends be, you know, committed to schools for sports, or their parents want them to go here, or people asking me, so, like, your major is sociology, like, what do you want to do with that? And then me being like,
not having any answers.
So
really nobody has the answers.
Yeah, it was definitely a really just kind of confusing time figuring out what it is I actually want to do. And why?
And I think that social media puts a lot of pressure on perfect lives. And when you feel like your life, although she has been to many third world countries, so she knows how lucky she is and how lucky we are, but you don't feel like you know what your thing is, what your gift is at that age. It's like sleepwalking, right? And until you can come to that. And so I just wanted, in my way, which is a creative way, to show her that this is what most people are feeling. We put really pretty things on Instagram, or that's the idea anyway, but it's not all authentic.
Yeah. It's not, and that's why I kind of love that this book puts a focus on stillness and kind of the meditation and the digital detox and kind of stepping away from the social media and the technology and taking time to figure out what's important to you and what you want to do.
Yeah, thank you for bringing that part up. That was a difficult aspect to write, because again, we wanted to keep it so authentic, like really what kid would do this coming from California and a privileged life. And so thank you for bringing that part up, because the truth is, the stillness and the meditation, or however someone can meditate, will lead you to peace. But it's so hard to grasp at 45, let alone 17, 19. And so what we tried to do were sprinkle in tools that help me for her generation, and hopefully a way that her generation can understand.
And what is your connection to things like kind of putting your phone down or not being on social media? Is that something you've been able to do or just something that you saw the character?
I mean, it's definitely a goal of mine. It's not the easiest thing in the world, but I do love to go to yoga classes. And my mom's always told me, before you go to bed, like, put your phone down at least 30 minutes before because it's not good to go to bed with the screen in your face and blah, blah, blah. So it's definitely something that I try to strive for and I work towards to be able to just kind of take a detox sometimes. And I also think when you're around people that you can just have fun with, like your friends, you don't need to be on the phone all the time. So it just depends.
I think, like you said, the main character so much is what I would strive to be at that age and what you would hope to be, right? So she comes to this really cool realization that at any age we hope to come to.
That's something I connected with as well. This is a young adult novel, which for me just means it maybe is like easier to read. But right. I think the themes that are explored are very universal, especially for women. There's just these things that I think every woman inside still feels 17 a lot.
Right, right. Including the original main character.
Shakuntala.
Yeah. She couldn't find her true love until she stood up for herself and put herself first. And at the time that that was written, that's kind of unheard of in that society. So
is that maybe the message you want young readers to take away, male or female? But
yeah, I think to not be afraid of, you know, the failure and adventure that being on your own brings and just growing up.
Yeah, definitely. And for me, the idea that you cannot have someone fall in love with you, you can't fall in love with someone else until you love yourself.
That's deep, guys. That's some real talk right there. That gets me. Also, I love the conversations about identity that are kind of sprinkled throughout the book.
In particular, you're trying to make some of them funny.
Yeah, and it is funny, right? If you're a person of color, you've probably encountered a lot of these things where people are trying to touch your hair or they say things that are just so ridiculous and racially insensitive that you have to laugh because you're like, they don't.
By the time we wrote it and we both really found those things funny, I guess you have a confidence, but it can happen to people and you can have no friends or family around that can support you. And it's shocking and it's hurtful. We tried to bring humor to it because humor is something that we use across the board all the time in the most dreadful of situations to bring the soul back to itself. So that's why we tried to make it funny, not that we were at all making light of it, because we've both gone through it.
It's just reflecting what is the reality. And I think for a lot of people, they don't know that they're still unaware of maybe.
They don't know that it's hurtful.
Right.
And that was the whole point, is that you can be really unaware of things that make other people so beautiful. You don't have to be insecure or fearful of it.
And so the book is impressive on its own, but you also have a lot of I guess celebrity fans of it.
I have some nice quotes.
So James Patterson, first of all, wrote the foreword.
Right.
And we talk about that. Guys, he's kind of a big deal.
Right. So there's no airport that we've ever gone through where his name wasn't
everywhere.
And so when I told Ava that this is the deal that we got, it was somewhat overwhelming because this man that is a genius at what he does was giving us a chance in his field. And I really appreciate, and I try to do the same in my field, but I so appreciate when someone opens the door and lets you come in and offers a hand. And that's how his company is set up, and that's how he's set up. We couldn't have done it without him.
Yeah. Did you get to meet with him, or he just was like gracious enough to be a part of it?
Gracious enough to be a part of it. He doesn't live in state. We don't live in state. So, but his team held our hands.
That's so sweet.
Yeah, the whole way.
Yeah. I also have to point out Kim Kardashian West wrote a little nice review on
that
front.
Was very sweet of her.
But Brian Grazer also jumped out at me on the back. He's obviously known for all of his amazing TV credits. And it made me think, is that somewhere you'd like the book to maybe go, is to be turned into a book or a movie or a TV show or something like that?
I mean, yeah, that would be amazing.
Absolutely. I mean, I think that the retelling of the story visually would just get to so many more eyeballs. And again, it's about entertaining someone, but really having a message there. We have a subplot that hopefully doesn't take over too much of the story, but about really serious issues of trafficking and things that are important to both of us, that both of us have worked on. Yeah.
And that's something that is in the book, but also has some relevance in reality, right? The trafficking aspect.
Yeah. I mean, in my industry, in the fashion industry, it is such a huge, huge problem of children that are trafficked into factory work. So that is super frustrating and heartbreaking. I work with a man named Kailash Satyarthi, who has saved over 80,000 children from working in factories, and has he's a Nobel laureate for his work, but also sex trafficking, and that's such a huge industry and so hard to tackle. Proceeds from the book go there. We have an organization that we've worked with. We've met some of the children her age that have been rescued. Some had babies. And so this was basically all we knew how to do was, you know, a creative form. So when I go and talk to young people, I remind them that they don't have to help by giving money. You can help in any situation that you're good at, right? So for me, it's being creative. For other people, it could be donating their time, teaching someone how to read, just whatever someone is good at. There's never enough to go around.
Definitely. And I think it's so important to get creative about the ways in which we raise awareness about different topics. Obviously, sex trafficking is something that we've heard about, but I think to put it in a young adult novel, to put it in very kind of casually in a storyline that wasn't beating you over the head, but also I think a lot of kids will be like, wait, but what is this? Or I want to learn more about this. Or maybe I want to make my own film about this. Or
well, my 10-year-old daughter, her sister started to ask questions because she wanted to know what it was. And it's a very sad tragedy that is a reality. And I would like all my kids to help.
So, Ava, you are a freshman in college.
Mm-hmm.
You are now a published author.
Yeah.
Did this inspire you to want to write more? Or did it in any way influence the path that you're on, do you think?
It definitely influenced the path that I'm on. I think that with anything that I end up doing in my life, I definitely want to have a give back aspect. There haven't been many books that I've seen really that have, you know, proceeds that go to a charity or something like that. So it just kind of showed me that with anything that I do, there's always a way for me to be able to give back and to educate people about things that they might not be aware of.
Yeah, definitely the first and probably even the second time Ava came to India with me, she would call home to friends and tell them about experiences that she was having. And I saw how hard it was for her. She was going through some heavy, heavy visuals. And she tried to explain to some of her close friends, and they just couldn't grasp it. And we talked about how it's okay. It's not something they've been exposed to, and they can be exposed through Ava.
And this book is in many ways a love letter to India and all the amazing things that people can experience there. And it's also really fun, and there's a love story, and there's a really important family component. So, guys, I really enjoyed reading it. I hope you check it out.
Thank you.
And 96 Words for Love is available now wherever books are sold.
Absolutely.
Give it up for Rachel Roy and Ava Dash.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.